Welcome to Nguyen Nam Podcast Channel. With their long, profuse double coat, the Old English sheepdog is the quintessential shaggy dog. You can't help but know one when you see one. But what about the bearded collie? Can you recognize those as readily? In fact, it can be easy to confuse these two members of the herding group. You might be lucky enough to meet a bearded collie and not even know it. Keep listening to learn more about these smart, shaggy breeds and how to tell them apart. Dale Meyer, the president of the Old English Sheepdog Club of America, has owned Old English Sheepdog since 1978 and has bred them since 1981. He feels the main similarities between the sheepdog and bearded collie are that both are herding breeds, both have long coats, and they can have similar coloring. Although he rarely sees people confuse the dogs when he's at dog shows, he thinks it takes a bit of familiarity before a person can tell the two breeds apart. David Williamson, corresponding secretary of the Bearded Collie Club of America and bearded collie owner for 35 years, has had a different experience. When walking my dogs somewhere besides my neighborhood, I have gotten stopped and asked if the dogs are Old English sheepdogs. I quickly run through my short spiel of the differences between the two breeds using my dogs as examples. Once at a four-day dog show, it was strange not to be asked if my dogs were Old English sheepdogs. I took it that folks who generally come to big shows know the difference between these two breeds. Williamson, a retired teacher who enjoys agility practices and shows, believes the parallels between the two breeds lie mainly in the coat. He feels the similarities in fur coloring and abundance confuse people. Plus, both dogs are medium-sized, and both have similar heads. As for differences, one obvious one is found behind the dog. The bearded collie has a long tail that's carried low while the Old English sheepdog has no tail. Williamson also points out the dogs move differently. The gait of a bearded collie is smooth and gives the impression that the dog could work all day. The gait of an Old English sheepdog is unique with its front end taking on a regular, straight-on trot, while its hindquarters have been described as a roll from side to side. Meyer, who judges the herding group, the working group, and some of the sporting group, has been judging the Old English sheepdogs since 1995. He agrees that the main likeness between the bearded collie and Old English sheepdogs is the long coat and the fact they can be colored in similar ways. As for differences, there are many, including body proportions, the muzzle, the stop where the muzzle meets the forehead, and eye color. And although they can have similar colors, Meyer explained the Old English sheepdogs are basically gray and white with any brown or fawn in the coat color considered a fault. On the other hand, the bearded collie comes in many different colors, including brown and fawn. Finally, although both dogs look shaggy to the novice, according to Meyer, the Old English sheepdog's coat is dense, profuse, and stands away from the body. The bearded collie's coat is double-coated as well, but not profuse and lays flat on the body. Untrimmed, it becomes much longer than an Old English sheepdog coat. The history of the Old English sheepdog shows the name to be a bit of a misnomer, as they aren't as old a breed as you might expect. They were developed in the early 19th century in the southwest of England, which is relatively recent in terms of many ancient dog breeds. In addition, they aren't completely English, as the dogs that contributed to the breed were either Scottish or Russian in origin. Finally, they aren't fully sheepdogs. The history of the Old English sheepdogs is as a herding dog, but more so as a drover driving livestock, mostly sheep, to market. The history of the bearded collie is a bit murkier in terms of dates and bloodlines. However, according to Williamson, they are a Scottish breed, and it's thought they originally were developed from the Polish lowland sheepdog. Historians of the breed believe the bearded collie was also used to drive cattle to market, but according to Williamson, they were developed originally to watch over and take care of the shepherd's sheep. The gentle and adaptable Old English sheepdogs is also known as the bobtail. They very much love people and want to be near them and with them constantly. They all have different personalities, but males tend to be more needy where females are more aloof. Williamson described the bearded collie's key trait as their loving, playful nature. In fact, he says many people refer to them as clowns. However, because their coats require an abnormal amount of care, they need an owner who can commit to a high-maintenance dog. Plus, these outgoing and fun-loving dogs have loads of energy. They are quite fun to live with, and they do require regular exercise. Most people have them as pets, and some folks compete with them in the herding and agility rings. Bottom line is they need daily exercise and attention. Both these hairy clowns are intelligent bundles of love. If you've got the time and energy to meet their needs, either would make a wonderful pet. And now you know whether you meet an old English sheepdog or a bearded collie on your next trip to the dog park, there's more than one Shaggy dog.